Good morning students. So in this class we are going to discuss about refraction. So the light passing from one optical medium to another optical medium through the boundary, that is refraction. So the law of refraction is also called Snell's law. So the angle of incidence and the angle of refraction, then the normal is perpendicular to the boundary, all lie in the same plane or coplanar. That is the first point of Snell's law. The second one, the angle of incidence in the first medium to the angle of refraction in the second medium is equal to the ratio of then the refractive index of second medium to the refractive index of first medium. So that is Snell's law. So that is sin I by sin r equal to n2 by n1. So we can write it as product form. So just cross multiply. So n1 sin I is equal to n2 sin r. So the angle of incidence in the first medium, then angle of refraction in the second medium. So that is n1 sin I equal to n2 sin r. So the ratio of angle of incidence in the first medium to the angle of refraction in the second medium is equal to the refractive index of second medium to the refractive index of first medium. Then, so the angle of deviation due to refraction. So the angle of deviation is angle between angle of incidence to the deviation. So the d is equal to I minus r if the light travels from rarer medium to denser medium. So consider rarer medium is here air, the denser medium is water. So the light passes from air to water. So the light refracts. So if it is, there is no medium, the light travels in a straight line. If there is a medium, it deviates from the original path. So if light travels from rarer to denser, the refracted ray, it's deviated towards the normal. So this is a normal that is perpendicular to the boundary. So the medium 1, that is air, so that n1 is less than n2. So the refractive index of air is 1, then water is greater than 1, it's around 1.3. So the light travels from rarer to denser, the deviated ray, that is refracted ray, deviates towards the normal. So the angle of deviation is I minus R. Then light travels from denser to rarer, just reverse case. So the angle of incidence, then the refracted ray, it deviates away from the normal. So this normal. So if light travels from denser to rarer, here n1 is greater than n2, here the denser medium. So light travels from denser to rarer, the refracted ray is away from the normal. So the light deviates away from the normal. So the angle of deviation is r minus I. Then simultaneous reflection and refraction. So the light incidence on a refracting surface, so there should be a reflection as well as refraction. So the incident ray and refracted ray, if you check the intensity, so the intensity of refracted ray is less than the incident ray. So light from the source, so the light incident on a reflecting surface, so part of light is reflected, part of light is refracted at the same time. That is simultaneous reflection and refraction. Then intensity of refracted ray is less than the incident ray. So in this class we have discussed refraction. So passing of light from one optical medium to another optical medium through the boundary. Then from the science Snell's law, that's n1 sin I is equal to n2 sin r. If light travels from rarer to denser, so light deviates towards the normal. If it is traveled from denser to rarer, so light travels, just the refracted ray is away from the normal. Then from the same source, so the incident ray, the part of light is reflected, then again the part of light is refracted from the same source. So that is simultaneous reflection as well as refraction.